Welcome. In this video, you will learn how to play Someone Like You by Adele. Make sure that your ukulele is tuned and also make sure that the nails on your chord hand are really short. This will make it so that you have very good form and then the strings will ring. If you would like to see more song tutorials like this one, unboxings, reviews, and learn how to play ukulele from scratch, then subscribe to this channel. Okay, let's get started. Let's go through the chords. But remember, anything you want to skip, you can check the timestamps down in the first comment. Okay, so our chords for this song are A. Play these with your peace fingers. If you did throw up a peace sign, those are the fingers you need. And I have my thumb in the back, kind of going across this way. So try not to carry the ukulele with your wrist. I do see some beginners carry, and then that gives them poor wrist form. So bring the thumb out and make like a C and do A this way. And then leave your middle finger here. That'll be your anchor. Slide down two frets to go to E. I know some people that like to do E this way, but my fingers don't work that way. If they work for you, go ahead and do it that way. But this is what we want for E. Okay, next we have F sharp minor. If you know how to do G7, it's just up one string. So it's the same shape, it's the triangle shape. And if you make the middle finger your anchor, it can stay there and you can go straight to D. So from F sharp minor to D, pretty easy transition. And the only difficult chord, but I will show you a way around it. The only difficult chord here is B minor. That's a bar chord. So you gotta squeeze on that one, use your arm, and we're barring on the second fret. And adding the ring finger on the fourth fret. You can try and find different places on your index finger where you can make the ring or add pressure with the middle finger as well. So now we're going to look at the chord form or the chord order for each of the sections, like intro, verse, pre-chorus, chorus, bridge. But if you know that already and you want to skip straight to the finger style, then skip to this point in the video. For the intro, we need A, E, F sharp minor, and D. Each chord gets 4 beats. So let's try it. If you can do it, let's do it together. If not, just watch the first time. 1, 2, ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you can strum all 4 times if you want to. It's just the way I did it right now buys you more time to switch between chords. So let's try it. 1, 2, at A, go. 1, 2, 3, E. F sharp minor. And the good news is that that same chord pattern goes straight into the verse and you repeat it 4 times. Throughout the song, we have this arpeggio pattern, and an arpeggio, or the word arpeggio, is just a fancy way of saying you're playing all of the notes in a chord in succession, like ascending or descending, going up or going down. So you can do that, and I think the easiest way to sound close to the piano is to assign each finger per string. Each finger's only gonna play that string. So the thumb is just gonna rest on G, index on C, middle on E, ring on A. And all you're gonna do is index, middle, ring, and then come back, middle, index. Anytime you're on the index, you count a beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. Try that with me. 1, 2, ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we typically switch chords. So try going to an A there and try that. 1, 2, ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's really pretty, right? Okay, now go to E and let's try it there. 1, 2, ready, go. And remember, as you do this, don't pull out. That makes a very like ding sound. So instead, just push up. And if you have nails, it's easier, of course. If you don't have nails, you can still do it. It'll just sound softer. This is without the nail. This is with it. So it sounds more crisp, but you can still do it. So as we play through each section of the song, you can strum downwards with me, which is what I do to make things easy, or you can do the finger pattern. So let's take it from the intro and try to go into the verse. Again, you can do the finger style, you can do the down strum. Here we go. 1, 2, intro, go. E, go. F sharp minor. D chord. Beginning. To go into the pre-chorus, and that's where we have that B minor. If you have not mastered the art of bar chords, remember I said there's a way around it. So you can play just the three bottom strings if you're doing the finger style, because you're just doing these three, right? Or you can do it this way, like rest your thumb on G and then each one finger has a string and pick this way. So I want you to have alternatives to cheat with so that you don't feel like you can't do a song just because it has bar chords. So this can be your new B minor. But make sure you're not doing all four strings because G is not in the B minor chord. Don't play G, just play these bottom three. And that is a B minor chord. Okay, so let's try the pre-chorus. Each one only has two beats, so you have to think ahead a lot faster. 1, 2, slowly go. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Let's try that again. 1, 2, ready, go. Keep going. If you wanted to do the fingerstyle on the pre-chorus, it would sound kind of like this. 1, 2, switch. 1, 2, switch. 2, switch. 1, 2, switch. So it's a little bit more technically demanding, but still really fun, and you can do it if you practice it. By the way, if any part of this lesson is too fast or too slow, you can click the settings icon on this side of the screen and change the speed to make it match where you want this video to go. Okay, let's go into the chorus. 1, 2, ready, go. Or you can strum twice like this. Ready, go. Or you can do the finger style. And keep going. Okay, so let's try that. 1, 2, at the chorus, go.
Never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you.
I think the only part of the song that is like the anomaly, it's like really different, would be the bridge. But still, it's all chords that we've played already. So watch me kind of count through it first and then we'll do it together. So we have E for four beats. 1, 2, 3, F sharp minor. 1, 2, D chord. And then the next only have two beats. 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Try that with me if you're ready. If not, just watch again. Or it sometimes helps to not use the strumming hand and to just do the like the chord shapes. And that way you can focus on one thing. So let's try that section. We'll take it slowly. One, two, ready, go.
Nothing compares, no worries or cares, regrets and mistakes their memories make. Who would have known how bittersweet this would taste?
And then we go into the chorus.
Never mind.
Okay, so now that you've had the opportunity to play all of the chunks of the song, you can play the whole song. You can do it on your own, but let's do a little bit of it together, okay? Here we go. One, two, at the intro, go. One, two, three, four. You enjoyed that tutorial for Adele, Someone Like You. If you want to record yourself and share it with somebody, remember we have a Reddit community where we share videos and photos and just, you know, just stuff about the ukulele life. As always, thank you so much for watching. I hope that you subscribe to this channel, and I hope to see you in the next one. Sayonara!